Good evening, and welcome to the program. Today we will be discussing a key aspect of physics that we physicists like to call momentum. Now, every object with a mass and a velocity has a certain momentum. It is defined as the relation between its mass and velocity, and thus the formula for momentum is P equals mv.
Yay!
Oh my god, this is so boring.
Why do all old physics movies have to be so boring?
Guys, this is fascinating. Did you know that if an object has a mass of 15 kilograms per 15 kilograms and it's going at a speed of 20 meters per second, then it's got a momentum of 300 kilogram meters per second? This is amazing.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Fascinating, isn't it? Now, we can change an object's momentum by increasing or decreasing either its mass, its velocity, or both. I'll leave those experiments to you young physicists at home. Now we'll move on to something a bit more interesting called impulse.
Oh my guys, this is actually the best part.
How many times have you seen this?
Well, not that many times, not that many. Nope.
Tell the truth now, Shomik. That's what I thought, Shomik. Look, I think we can make a video that's 10 times better than this video.
Yeah, great idea, let's do it. And you know what? I know just where to do it.
Impulse is defined as the rate of change of momentum over a specific period of time, which is directly proportionate to the force applied. Thus, our new formula is delta P equals F delta T.
Yay!
How is this scientific?
To be honest, I'm having my doubts too.
Ah, come on, you chickens. Look, if our combined weight is about 15,000 newtons, and we went from 0 to 100 kilometers with a force of 6.40 times 10 to the power of 4 acting on us, then what's our impulse?
Ah, oh, wow.
I'm pretty sure that's 5.74 unit seconds.
Now that we've done that, why don't we slow down?
Yeah.
I'm trying to, but it's not working.
Simply amazing, isn't it? Now, you'll see from the previous demonstration that a newton second and a kilogram meter per second is identical and is in fact interchangeable. It is exactly their equality that allows us to manipulate the two formulas that we already have into a new formula. F delta T equals delta MV. Well, that was neat. Now, you'll notice that the previous experiment closely resembles a collision, which is exactly what we'll be studying next. Now, the first kind is elastic, where two objects hit each other and then go off separately. As you can see, with our demonstration, we have one object of 54 kilograms moving at a velocity of 5 meters per second, which collides into a stationary object of equal mass. Now, through simple manipulation of our formula, we can find their individual velocities after the impact. Well, that was rather speedy. Let's see it again.
I thought you said this wasn't gonna hurt.
Well, that was quite the entertaining lesson today, folks. I want to remind you that while these experiments, though seemingly simple, are actually quite dangerous.
Inside, 'cause it's embedded in my soul. The day I stop, I'll be the day I turn cold.